Dear brothers and sisters, I greet you all in the matchless name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and welcome you all to this gracious word program. May the grace of God and peace of Christ be with us all as we study the God's word. In today's lesson, we'll be meditating from the text, Colossians chapter 3 verses 16 to 21. Especially in this part, the verses 18 to 21 tells about values of a Christian family or the God's design for a family. We should know that there were two valuable institutions directly made by God. The first one is the family. He first made Adam and then he made Eve, and they were family made by God. So the first valuable institution made by God is the family. So in this part we have specific instruction for each and every individual in the family. The second valuable institution is the church, which is purchased by the blood of Jesus Christ. It's a valuable one. It's God's family. So in this world we have a family that is made by God, and we have God's family, the church, purchased by the blood of Jesus Christ. So in this part, it from 18 to 21, let's read and find out some important findings. Wives, submit to your own husbands as it is fitting in the Lord. So the instruction for the wives in the family is submit to your own husband. In other words, we can say obey your husband. So it's God's instruction to the family, especially to the wives. So the wives, whosoever submits to their husbands, respects God's word. So while doing such thing, the wives, they will be honoring God's word, my dear brothers and sisters. The verse 19 says like this: husbands, love your wives and do not be bitter toward them. We can see that it doesn't say love your wives alone, but it adds do not be bitter toward them. It's a natural thing happening in every family, most of the families. The husbands, having the authority, they treat the wives as slaves and they show bitterness towards them. So only God's valuable family has instructions to the husbands to love their wives and not to be showing bitterness to them. So we have to obey these commandments as husbands and as wives. The wives need to be submitting to the husband or obeying to the husband. The husband needs to love their wife and they must not show bitterness towards them. The third one, verse 20 says, children, obey your parents in all things, for this is well pleasing to the Lord. In many families in present generation, we can see that children are not satisfied with their behavior of their parents. They are not happy about the instructions from their parents. But the word of God says, my dear children, you have to obey your parents, because for this is pleasing to the Lord. This may not be pleasing to you. When I use the mobile phone often, when I want to play, when I wish, there are some instructions from the parents. Do not do that. Keep it limited. Do this. So it's not pleasing to me as a child, but obey your parents because it's pleasing to the Lord. Since it's pleasing to the Lord, since the Bible tells, obey your parents and children will be blessed by that. The fourth instruction is to the fathers. Fathers, do not provoke your children, lest they become disgraced. This is also happening in most of the families. Fathers provoking their children. They are always showing the angry faces to their children. This is happening in most of the families. Fathers provoking their children. Fathers are always showing their angry faces to their children. Fathers making their children to stand against them by their words and actions. So, fathers, we have to obey the word of God. In this manner, fathers, Do not provoke your children, lest they become discouraged. Let their heart not become discouraged. Let the binding continue, family binding continue. Let the children be in the family. Let them not go out of the family. I mean, they will be present bodily in the family, but their mind will always be outside. They will be liking the friends more than the parents. They will be wanting to be with the friends or the person one who hears to them or one who spends times with them. So, they will be wanting to be with them than being with the brothers and sisters. So, the binding continue. So, these are the instructions for the wives, husbands, children and fathers, those who are in the family. This is God's design for a family. When we keep this design, when we honor these values, these instructions, then this family will be a blessed family. Let me add two more verses with this part so that we can know how a family can be blessed. Let us read chapter 3 verse 16 in Colossians. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom. For a family to be blessed by the Lord, for a family to keep the value what the word of God has given, for the family to follow the God's design that is given by the Almighty God, they have to keep in their family the word of Christ. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom. Family without the word of God, a family which does not give importance to the word of God, will be a family with failures. But here we can see each and every member in the family has to accept their responsibilities for fulfilling this one. I have to respect God, I have to respect each and everyone in my family. If one member in the family is not following the word of God and keeping up to the mark of the values of the family, then it's going to be a losing family, a family which does not enjoy the blessings of God. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, a family has to be in Christ to be a safe and blessed family. I repeat, a family has to be in Christ to be a safe and blessed family. Let's read Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places in Christ. In Christ, we have every spiritual blessing. So only I repeat, a family has to be in Christ to enjoy the blessings of the Word of God and the heavenly blessings. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us with every spiritual blessing. We have been blessed with every spiritual blessings in Christ. To enjoy those spiritual blessings, a family, each and every member has to be in Christ. Kindly instruct your children to read the word of God daily, pray to God daily. Let the elderly people set an example for this. In all our busy schedules, let us follow this pattern. Let us read the Bible. Let us pray, let us sing songs so that the children follow the same. Bible in Deuteronomy chapter 6, it tells that the father or the parents, especially the father, has to lead their children holding their hands. They have to instruct them in the word of God. They have to teach them the word of God. They have to always speak with them, the children, the word of God from the Bible. So, we have to follow that so that our family will be a valuable one with God's value. My dear brothers and sisters, let's conclude this message by seeing some example, especially Noah's example. Let's remember that Noah and his family were safe inside the ark. All the whole world at that part of time, at that time, they were destroyed in the flood because of disobedience. But Noah and his family were safe inside the ark since they were obedient people to God. So, let's remember this one. When we are keeping up the values of Word of God in our family, when we are obedient to the Word of God, when we obey the commandments of God, I remind once again, the wives has to submit to the husband. The husband has to love their wife. The children has to obey their parents. The father must not provoke their children, and they have to be lovable parents. So, when we are keeping these values in our family, then remember, as the Noah's family were safe inside the ark among the biggest flood, then our family will be safe in Christ in this perishable world, in this evil world. So, let's remember this one. Our family is blessed by God with the Word of God when we are being in Christ. Let's remember there is safety in the family. When we are facing rain and when we are facing heavy sunshine, we want to be inside our family, inside our house, with the family. When we have any challenges, we want the family members to be with us to face those challenges. So, God is with us. God has given some specific commandments, some instructions for the family members to follow. So, each and every one of the family members has to do their part, and they have to be in Christ, and they have to follow the Word of Christ, and they have to pray, and they have to follow the instructions given by the Bible, so that their family can be an example to other families. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful time to hear your word. We have seen today how a family can be valuable one, a blessed family. When we follow the commandments of God, when we follow the Word of God, our family can be a blessed family. So help us to be like that. Let me fulfill my responsibility in my family. Being a wife, being an husband, being a children, being a father or mother, let me obey the commandments of God. Let me follow my part and make my family a blessed one. In Jesus Christ we pray. Amen.
It is God's will that you must be saved. First, listen to the Bible truth. And you must believe the truth. Then you must repent from your sinful life. Then you must confess by words that the Lord Jesus Christ as the Son of God. You must be baptized for the remission of your sins. Every day our Lord added those who were being saved into his church. Be blessed by studying the Word of God. To receive the Voice of Truth International magazine and to study the Bible systematically through our English Bible Correspondent course, kindly write to us. Our address, Gracious Word, P.O. Box 15, Arasradi, Madurai, 625016, Tamil Nadu. For more details, dial 9244204420, 9244214421. God bless you.
The Church of Christ salutes you.